Hi guys. Today I will show you how to write a strong dissertation proposal with detailed example. Let's start with why dissertation proposal. Why it is important.
Proposal is one of the most important documents that you will write before actually starting your PhD or your research program. It defines a question and describes the approach that you are going to take to answer that question. It also places your work within the realm of the research that's currently out there and show value proposition of your work. We can clearly tell you what needs to be included, what should definitely not be included, and sort of what the structure of a research proposal should be. Without a proposal, there is no plan, and without a plan, there is no project. That is the key thing to take away. You need a proposal. If you are watching this video, you are probably stuck. You are probably thinking, well, I have to write a proposal. I don't know where to begin. By the end of today's video, you will walk away with a draft outline or rough outline of a proposal, and you will be work on that, and then possibly submit. Meanwhile, please like and subscribe the channel for more fun and education videos, and stay tuned to complete dissertation proposal. Let's start with proposal structure. The structure of the proposal includes 8 different sections and is approximately 2000 to about 2500 words. Remember that number. It should never be too short and also should not be too long. It includes following sections. Proposal starts with the title, followed by abstract, and then research background, research questions, research methods, significance, timeline, and the last, bibliography. We will be breaking down each of those sections and telling you what should be included in each of those parts. Please note that the sections might change depending upon your university or topic, but these sections provide a baseline and the fundamentals are expected to be remain same. So starting off with your title, think about what keywords defines your project. If someone were to search your work, consider these questions. What unique keywords would identify your particular project? How would you describe your research? Does given title justify your research? What are the terms that you need to include to be able to say, this is the work I am doing? Remember that this is the section that will definitely change the title that you propose in the beginning. It will be revised as you go along, depending on the direction that your project takes in the end. So, don't get pressurized to find the best title. Just write down few titles and proceed. Once you complete writing your proposal, you can always come back and change the title. Here we start section 2, which is abstract. An abstract is a short summary of a larger work. The abstract concisely reports the aims and outcomes of your research, so that readers know exactly what the proposal is about. Since this is a dissertation proposal, so you can write a short summary about issues you are concerned with and that you are going to be kind of focusing in this proposal. An abstract is usually around 100 to 200 words, but there's often a strict word limit, so make sure to check the requirements. Here, the recommendation is, you write it after completing other sections of the proposal document. It should be a completely independent, self-contained text, not an excerpt copied from your paper or dissertation. An abstract should be fully understandable on its own to someone who hasn't read your full paper or related sources. Third section is research background. Research background is a bit like literature review, but a bit more concise than traditional literature review. This section explains why this particular research topic is important and essential to understanding the main aspects of the study, current knowledge, allowing you to identify relevant theories, methods, and gaps in the existing research. In order to justify the gaps in the existing research, you should have done a lot of reading to understand where your work is going to fit into the field, and that is where you are going to describe what that field is. What information does the reader need to know to understand your field? What information does the reader need to know what gap there is in literature? This will show whether you have done the most exhaustive reading or not, so don't underestimate the importance of this section. Let's discuss little about how you should structure the research background section. Authors should briefly highlight the main developments of their research topic and identify the main gaps that need to be addressed. In other words, this section should give an overview of your study. The section should be organized as: what is known about the broad topic? What are the gaps or missing links that need to be addressed? What is the significance of addressing those gaps? What are the rationale and hypothesis of your study? While writing an effective background, you ought to steer clear of some mistakes. The most common mistakes in writing the background include the following. Don't write a background that is too long or too short. Focus on including all the important details but write concisely. Don't be ambiguous. Writing in a way that does not convey the message to the readers defeats the purpose of the background, so express yourself keeping in mind that the reader does not know your research intimately. Don't discuss unrelated themes. Try and center your discussion around the pivotal aspects of your research topic, that is, highlight the gaps in the literature, state the novelty of the study, and the need to conduct the study. Don't be disorganized. Not discussing the themes in a chronological manner can confuse the reader about the progress in the field, so try and organize your writing carefully. Here is section 4, Research Questions. A good research question is essential to guide your research paper, project or thesis. It pinpoints exactly what you want to find out and gives your work a clear focus and purpose. All research questions should be focused on a single problem or issue, researchable using primary and/or secondary sources, feasible to answer within the time frame and practical constraints, specific enough to answer thoroughly, complex enough to develop the answer over the space of a paper or thesis, relevant to your field of study and or society more broadly. Here the most important thing is, you need to really think about where your research fits into the field, whether your questions are feasible. Have they been answered before? If yes, that's not an original study. It needs to provide new information to the field, a new sort of insight, new direction, and new consideration. Let's look at some example questions. The way you frame your question depends on what your research aims to achieve. The table here shows some examples of how you might formulate questions for different purposes. Take some time to review these example questions and try to write down similar to your research. Here we reached our next section, which is the research methods, or simply methodology. It's usually the bulkiest and most significant. You are defining your strategy right now. You stated the problem, the knowledge gap, and how you intend to address it. Methodology section is majorly divided into two procedures: collecting the data and analyzing the data. For collecting the data, you have to think about few items like: have you chosen quantitative or qualitative, and why? Primary versus secondary, will you collect original data yourself, or will you use data that has already been collected by someone else? Descriptive versus experimental, will you take measurements of something as it is, or will you perform an experiment? You need to say why you have chosen it and justify the choices that you made. This area if your research proposal is the most important in determining the success of your project, as it is the most weighted section. Next is analyzing the data. How are you going to analyze the data? How are you planning to collate that data? For quantitative data, you can use statistical analysis methods to test relationships between variables. For qualitative data, you can use methods such as thematic analysis to interpret patterns and meanings in the data. Ultimately, remember that research proposal is purely just a proposal. You are not meant to be an expert. You are not meant to know all the answers, but you are meant to have considered and looked at the research out there and thought about what ways have people done it before. The most important part of methodology is noting down your future challenges. You should also evaluate the constraints that many people overlook. They don't say what concerns or challenges they might face. People miss this because they don't want to admit that there could be a problem. However, if you are trying to collect data from a cell type that's uncommon or difficult to find, or if you are trying to interview people in war region, it's important that you say, right, these are the challenges that I could be faced with and this is how I am planning to overcome them. This shows you got the correct sort of research mindset, where you are considering challenges, considering outcomes, you are considering options. Let's go through the section 6, which is significance. The significance of the study, quite simply, is the importance of the study to the field, what new insights/information it will yield, how it will benefit the target population, very simply, why it needs to be conducted. Consider these questions while writing significance section. Why is this work significant? What do you hope to learn from it? How is your work original? What new perspective will you bring? How does the work build on what we already know? Now let's listen at one such detailed example of significance section. For instance, given the current COVID pandemic situation, you may wish to conduct research on whether a lockdown is the right solution for controlling a pandemic. Based on your research question and methodology, you will have to talk about the potential insights your study may yield, so that it could provide pointers to researchers and governments alike on how to implement, manage, relax, or possibly even avoid lockdowns as a strategy for controlling pandemics. Hope this gives an idea where you can try to write significance for your proposal. Next section is timeline. A dissertation timeline includes a series of milestones that leads up to the dissertation defense, revisions, and final submission of your dissertation. Constructing an outline of every step in the dissertation process, including rough estimates of how long each will take, will give you a realistic picture of where you are in the process at any given time. You can create timeline something like this, in Word document or Excel sheets. We reached to the last section, which is bibliography. Here, you want to detail the key pieces of work and the key literature that your work is based on. It includes all the sources you consulted in your research. What is that paper from where you have taken references? What are the pieces of proposal literature that you, for example, read and then based your questions on? Where was the gap in what you read and then thought to answer that? Let's say, a person is very new to your topic, what other papers would he has to read to understand the field and then understand how your work is going to add to that field and build on that field? That is what you need to think again and remember, that the lecturer or the professors, the supervisor that you're applied to, will be an expert in that field. Do consider the amount of reading that you have done and make sure that you have done enough to be able to have picked out the whose papers are. Here are few examples for bibliography just for references. Wow, We have completed all the sections on how to write dissertation proposal. It's not difficult to write, especially if you know your literature and you know the sort of questions that you are thinking about writing. It's a document with a very simple and consistent structure. If you really want to make it a success, make a habit of writing the dissertation daily. No matter what increment of time you start with for outlining, drafting, and revising your dissertation, it's important to work on it every day. Shorter daily writing sessions are far less overwhelming than fevered marathons that will test both your endurance and your sanity. Do yourself a favor by starting small and showing up for yourself every single day. Thank you for watching my video. Hope you can get easily started writing your dissertation proposal.